My name is Shweta Kaushik and I have given the exam for evolution of air interface towards 5G. Yeah, actually I was interested in knowing about 5G because right now we are having like 4G we are having, you know. And basically I wanted to know ki what are the problems with 5G, and it's going to come maybe in end of the 2019 it will be here to us, and that's why I want to just know about it ki jo hai ya, how we are proceeding, how just these things started, like from digital communication, how that has started. So I would like to know that. That's why I had a great interest, because simply I'm from electronics and communication, that is actually that is different thing, but still as a person we are, what technologies we are going on, that we should know. That's why I just did this course, because I wanted to know about it.
Okay. Oh, happy, what all the things that you thought were there in the course?
Yeah, of course they all were there. What actually I was expecting ki I should know what, see like what happened, no, we are when operating our phone and we just turn our internet on, we get it H plus written there. So most of the people don't know what does that mean. We are working with 4G and H plus is there, so they think yeah, oh my god, how much speed is coming. It's like we, this our internet is too fast. But what happens, H plus actually it is not 4G, it is 3G, still it is 3G, and you should know about that. So these small things, no, you should be knowing about them. So that's quite good enough that I was, and moreover lectures was quite good, professor was very good, he used to explain everything very nicely. I'll really thankful to him ki, because that he made it possible that I gave the exam, and definitely it was very nice, very nice I got it. Yes, I have actually explored before ki Coursera, edX and many more platforms are there that I can work on, upon I can actually learn from. I did from Coursera. First of all, we need to learn something. The platform doesn't matter anyhow, but something that matters financially, that's the problem actually with most of the students, that they cannot pay 3,000, 5,000, 6,000 for any other courses there. And in small amount of money is there, and you are getting so nice professors, and they are Indian professors. You are getting your own Indian institute. You are getting, then why can't you do it from NPTEL only if you are getting everything there? So that doesn't mean that you need to go upon other courses like EDX and Coursera. NPTEL was quite a nice experience for me, because that was my first exam I gave today, and that was really awesome.
Next course, what is yours?
Next course I will be doing CMOS using VLSI and digital DLD, actually digital logic design. These two I am going to do after my exams, this semester exam. At the end of May I will be starting those courses. Yes.
All the best.
Thank you.
Okay, my name is Mustafa Kamal. I study in JSS Noida. I am basically from Kanpur. My exam was inspection and quality. Yeah, in manufacturing.
How was the course and how was the exam?
Course was moderate, but the exam was pretty easy, because the second part of the paper was from assignment only. So almost 10 questions were from assignment only. So rest of the questions were not so difficult. Some of them were numerical. I was not expecting that, because most of the syllabus was not numerical. Very few were they were formulas. So I wasn't expecting, but they were also not difficult, because some of them were just basic questions from my graduate studies. So it was well, I couldn't do like around 5 to 6 questions, and so I guessed it, because there was no negative marking. First of all, the thing is that the faculties they are teaching are very good in respect to knowledge. The knowledge is pretty deep. So, and the second most important thing is, if you choose any course, irrespective of your branch, they start your course from the very basic, from the scratch. So even if you don't have any knowledge, suppose you just have started the subject for the first time, you'll understand each and everything. And the third thing is, obviously the video lecture is quite clarifying, but they have the PDF. So you can also, you know, video lecture takes time, so for the quick revision you can use a PDF. So second point is the most important thing, because they start from the scratch, and even if you don't know anything, you will understand each and everything. Everybody knows in my class, but it depends on how many students take interest and how many of them have time to, you know, pursue the course for the entire semester, because this course takes, you know, consistency. You have to submit assignment each and every week. So you have to give your time to the course. You cannot just appear for the exam at the last moment. So it depends on how much time do they have and how much interest they have.
I have given TAEL, Teaching and Learning in Engineering. It actually enhances my, because I am a faculty in Calcutta College of Engineering and Technology, so it can enhance my own, you know, teaching capacity, and I can understand more the criteria of NBA and outcome-based education, which is the requirement of today's education.
How was the course structured and about the faculty?
It was good. It was good, and faculty is also good. The structure is more, you know, better. And the exam pattern is also good. I mean, I am satisfied with the exam. The assignments are good, but sometimes there are technical problems which we are facing. But I think it has been well taken care of at the last. So I think these can be more improved in future. Overall, it is good, but yes, the room for improvement is very, very large. So it can be more improved in a better way.
Asha Dwivedi, I am from Kite Group of Institutions, Ghaziabad. CMOS Digital Wheelside Design.
Same course, Devrish Mishra from Kite Group of Institution, course optate CMOS VLSI Design.
Sir, because I have the interest in this core area, because this course is interested in my core stream. That's why I chosen this.
Actually, the content provided by the NPTEL is excellent. Actually, quality of content, I'm talking about the quality of content. I've gone through the Khan Academy, EDX. But quality of content of NPTEL is much more better than the both there.
The content or the question level is not matched with the providing lectures which professors will give in. So it's too hard for us to track the questions.
Really, the course we have opted for is totally a theoretical based. But we have found there was much more numerical could have been there in the assignments or in the well teacher was explaining, but it was not there.
No, question didn't come from out of syllabus, but the assignment level is a basic one, but the question level, the question paper level is a hard one. So we cannot easy to tackle the questions.
Actually, I think the content covered can be much more higher level. They have covered in the NPTEL courses. And the question paper was pretty, we have to go on through the books, not actually the course covered in the NPTEL was not content was little less.
Exam center restroom are not very comfortable for us because it's too hot there. So we are not able to focus on the examination.
I think the course content could have been more better. And actually we have opted for CMOS VLSI, which was 8 weeks. It could have been 12 weeks for covering all the contents, escaping few contents. They have escaped few, but I think they could have extended it to 12 weeks and covered all the contents.
But anyway, this course, after you studied for NPTEL, did it help you in your college studies or anything?
Of course, it will obviously help us in the future requirement, because it's a core stream course.
Actually, companies in our college, CMOS, VLSI design related companies come, and we can use that. It will be very much, because NPTEL has a trademark, it has set up the level. And every company is taking as a level, so it will be definitely beneficial for us.
I'm Dr. Jitendra Singh, and currently at present I'm working with SNM, SM University, Delhi NCR campus. I'm pursued C programming program. Everything is good. I think video lectures are very good, experienced faculties, and this is my second course actually.
Oh, I see. What was the first one?
First one, educational leadership I have done last semester. This time I have done C programming. It's a refresher course I have done. Sir, it is good for all levels. Actually, it is good for beginner level also. Suppose somebody want to start some course. Or I have done this course previously also during my studies, C programming. And I am teaching this course also. I am a mentor of this course also. I am mentoring students.
Saxena and exam was quite average. It was not tough, neither easy. It was very good, and whatever was taught, I was able to attempt questions in one attempt. Like, it was very good experience. Facility of water was not there, and it was a bit hot in the computer labs.
It was not temperature.
No. AC was not there, so it was quite difficult to attempt the exam. It was very good. I was able to get, if I was having any query, I discussed on discussed forum and it was quickly answerable. It was like, it took either not more than 3 hours to answer my questions. Yeah, it was very good experience. This was my second course, embedded designing verification. And I came to know about it from my friends. Yeah, so I thought that they are telling me to update on it, so I was like, okay, let me try. So I tried on it and it was a good experience.
My name is Rajpriya and I maine C programming ka exam diya hai jo ki kafi acche the, questions acche the, kafi acha gaya paper, bahut hi acha. Jo sir hame padhate the unhone kafi acche se padhaya aur jaise wo padhate the usi types ke questions bhi aaye, kafi acha tha jo bhi hai. Everything was perfect. Garmi thi hai, garmi bahut hai aur thoda pani wagar ki facilities honi chahiye thi, warna sab better hai.
Palak Gupta and I opt for NPTEL. My course was financial analysis and reporting. Because I am from finance background and I like to work in finance. So because of my specialization, I opt this course. Some was overall good. From day one, the things I read, the paper was only based on that. Not out of course or the questions that is very hard or tough. Not like that. All over exam is easy. I attempt all assignments. I left two or three because of my job.
And then how did you find time to go through the NPTEL course in the
After coming from my office at 9 o'clock, I prepared for NPTEL. I am in second year of MBA. Yes. And it is compulsory in our college to attempt NPTEL.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Yes, I am very happy and it's my good experience to go for NPTEL. I got to learn about new things and my base is almost clear regarding to NPTEL. Or my course like financial accountant. Yes.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir. Have a nice day.
My name is Kumar Paraswani. I'm from ABS Engineering College from Electrical Branch. And about the course, I want to say that the teacher
was
C programming, training with C. So teacher was good. He was having a deep knowledge about the subject. And he finished the courses in like 30 minutes. He gives all the details which was necessary and no extra like bothering. Like we know the basics, but we want to have the knowledge of some advanced level. And that is what we are getting from this course. And overall, it was a good experience.
My name is Shubham Saini and I am BTEC third year student. My course name is Big Data Computing. I am studying from lecturer from IIT Patna, Mr. Rajiv Mishra sir. Basically, the plan is that I am learning daily 1 hour.
Sirf ek ghanta.
Consistent. Yes. Daily ek ghanta padhata tha. Lekin regular, wo jo consistency honi chahiye, wo honi chahiye bilkul. To ek ghanta regular padhata tha, to lecture mere ko aisa bol nahi gaya. Aur saath mein लेक्चर की नोट्स बनाता था, जैसे कि वहाँ पे ना वो सर मतलब डिफाइन भी करते रहते थे, तो वो अलग से भी कुछ लिखते थे वहाँ पे. वैसे तो थ्योरेटिकल टॉपिक है पूरा, लेकिन वो अलग से भी लिखते थे, तो मैं उसको भी नोट कर लेता था. और वही मतलब मेन एग्ज़ाम में आया हुआ था और सारे असाइनमेंट के थे, तो असाइनमेंट से रिलेटेड ही पूरे क्वेश्चन रखे हुए थे वहाँ पे. तो ये बहुत बेनिफिशियल रहा मेरे लिए. और थोड़े से मैंने ऑनलाइन क्वेश्चन मतलब कुछ वेबसाइट है उससे मतलब मैंने क्वेश्चन अटैम्प्ट किए थे, वहाँ से काफ़ी क्वेश्चन उठ के आए. बेसिकली क्या है, अगर आप कंसिस्टेंसी से मतलब डेली 1 आवर पढ़ो बस, तो कोई भी कोर्स टफ नहीं है ये. और मेरे मार्क्स आई थिंक 75% तक आ जाएगा हमसे. असाइनमेंट में 3 असाइनमेंट में तो 100 मार्क्स आए स्कोर किए, ठीक है. बाकी में 85-88 कुछ इस तरीके से स्कोर किया है, तो उसमें से भी 25 का ही मतलब मेन एग्ज़ाम में जुड़ता है. तो उसका 25 में से लगभग जब उस जो मतलब उसमें से है ना 8 असाइनमेंट से टॉप 6 का स्कोर 25 काउंट होता है, तो मेरे 88 भी आ रहे हैं ना, लेकिन वो ओवरऑल एवरेज हो गया ना, मतलब मेरे 25 में से 23 मेरे को वहाँ पे मिल जाएगी. और मैं यहाँ पे 75 में से 50 भी स्कोर करता हूँ, तो 75 ओवरऑल हो जाएगा.
बिना NPTEL और NPTEL के साथ में आपके कॉलेज में मार्क्स में क्या फ़र्क पड़ रहा है?
मार्क्स में इतना ज़्यादा फ़र्क तो नहीं पड़ रहा है, लेकिन जो स्किल डेवलप हो रही है वो बहुत अच्छी है, क्योंकि कॉलेज में इस तरह की कोर्स नहीं है ना, तो वो स्किल डेवलप नहीं हो पाई. और इस कोर्स को करने से इस तरह की स्किल्स सीखने को मिलते हैं, जैसे बहुत सी प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज सीखने को मिलते हैं, ऊपर से बहुत सारे मतलब सर्विस प्रोवाइड कराते हैं, ऑनलाइन के लिए, मतलब जैसे जो चीज़ें हमें मतलब कॉलेज प्रोवाइड नहीं करा पाता वो चीज़ें मतलब हमें यहाँ पे प्रोवाइड होती है, जो स्टूडेंट मतलब इस इन कोर्स को मतलब अप्लाई करते हैं इनके लिए, तो वो बहुत बेनिफिशियल रहा है स्किल सीखने के लिए, बहुत बेनिफिशियल है। मतलब नॉलेज आपको मिलते हैं, मतलब आप मार्क्स के लिए नहीं, नॉलेज के लिए आप कोर्स ज्वाइन कर रहे हैं। अब कॉलेज में क्या है, कॉलेज में मार्क्स का तो इतना ज़्यादा फर्क नहीं, लेकिन जो बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट होते हैं जो, वो बहुत ज़्यादा क्लियर हो जाते हैं आपके, तो वहाँ पे बहुत बेनिफिट मिलता है NPTEL कोर्स का।
कबीर, एंड आई एम फ्रॉम SRM इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, एंड आई हैव अपीयर्ड फॉर द कोर्स ऑफ प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग एंड प्रोग्रामिंग इन सी लैंग्वेज। टू माई एक्सपेक्टेशन, हाउ एज मच आई प्रिपेयर्ड, आई डिड दैट अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट टीचर्स, द टीचर मेंटर हु took the classes was very cooperating, and he repeated the things very well, unlike the other like online courses where we have to go through the links and find the information. It was there, all the notes and the video lectures, all the content was there itself in the programs. Yes, it was good, it was nice, it was not like the other websites, it was good. I feel it is worth paying the fees. I learnt a lot from it, so I think it was worthy.
What are you planning to use a certificate for?
Like future for my placements, I think it will help me.
Are you going for further studies?
For now, I am thinking to do MS. For now, like, Other than that, if not MS, then I would be pursuing M.Tech.
How long have you been aware of NPTEL?
Last year. I got to know it from the college teachers, last year only.
And yeah, how many of your friends are writing exam?
I think maybe in my class, 2 or 3 of them would be writing, not many, as not everyone would be knowing about it.
And I like the way questions are medium and average as well.
4.5.
Thank you so much. Okay. It's Prachi Vashish, and I took exam of English language for competitive exams, and it was good. Yes, the videos, the lectures were also very nice, and yes, the exam was up to the level. Yes, you can take some new lessons from this, how to prepare next time and do.
Were you able to attempt all the assignments?
No, I left 2 exams because of my college exams, and the date of submission passed. I took late notice of that, and I'm very much indignant of that. Yes, we can download the videos at any time. There was no time limit that you cannot watch videos. Or yes, the lecture was also good. नए हमें पता चले, हमारे लेवल्स हमें पता चले, व्हाट स्टेज वी आर स्टैंडिंग एट. यस, एंड फॉर एग्जांपल आई गेव फॉर इंग्लिश, एंड यस वी फॉर फर्दर लाइक इंटरव्यू वी आर गोइंग टू यूज दीज लेसन्स, दोज ग्रामेटिकल मिस्टेक्स व्हाट वी मेक इन इंटरव्यूज वी आर गोइंग टू करेक्ट देम. So yes, they will go. This exam is going to help me in future.
Any sir?
Expectations puri kari hai in NPTEL ne, and yes, it was good. And my course was DBMS Management System. Actually, we are studying that course in our college.
Nitin, okay, having studied DBMS in the college, why did you choose the same DBMS in NPTEL?
Any reason for that?
Sir, because NPTEL is conducted by IIT, so that I think IIT is advanced level, and the course was very good, and lectures was very good, so that's why.
Was there any difference than what is taught, DBMS taught in your college and your college?
Yes, sir, there was very much difference. That they made the concept very much clear, and I like to study from lectures. Best explanation about any concept, and the course was in deep, and assignments and the submission dates, so that we can complete them at time. Sometimes we are lazy and we don't want to do them, so they have the submission dates, last submission dates, so that we can do them from time. And this exams, by taking exam we will
it makes sure that we will study the syllabus seriously to clear that for that exam.
You'll be getting the certificate very soon, I think.
Yes.
Yeah, and you might be also happy. I think you have done very well. What do you want to do with the certificate? What are you going to use
for? Sir, I think so that it will help me in my career to achieve my goals.
You're doing a graduation now?
Yes, sir.
You're planning to do a post-graduation also?
Not now, but still I'm planning for my placements.
Oh, okay. But I think even after you are placed somewhere, you can definitely go through NPTEL course.
Yes,
are you aware of that? You can study anytime.
Okay, I was not aware of that.
You can, okay, sir. Nothing,
That is a very good point for NPTEL exam. Yes, sir. Many teachers asked from my college also, but still we were not sure about that, that they can also give exam. Only today we come to know that they are also giving the exam. They are also eligible for giving the exam.
Please,
sir, these NPTEL courses make the concept very much clearer and also create the interest in the particular subject opting for that.
Arul Kundra, working as a senior assistant professor in ABES Engineering College. And the course which I have opted was C language, programming in C. So it was really a fantastic experience being as a faculty. Should I speak in Hindi or English? Whatever I feel like.
Anything.
So what being as a faculty, the kind of question which I have solved was really up to about the level. And if the kind of knowledge which I have or a student will gain from NPTEL, it's really a very fantastic thing. So I must appreciate IIT for doing such a good job, and which is definitely going to help the entire teaching fraternity and student fraternity. This is one of the best program which is initiated by IIT and IISc Bangalore. That is very fantastic. The thing is this, I was with maximum of my college student, and it is very good to see that the maximum of them were from non-computer branch. They were from EC branch. So even you can find the person who is non-related with computer sciences coming and appearing for C language, and they were very happy, and there was a same kind of reaction from them also. They are getting a good opportunity, and because definitely maximum of the student are getting opportunity in IT fields nowadays, even though they are from EC or civil, but maximum opportunity what they are getting from computer science. So it's one of the best way, and even in core field also, agar apne core field mein apne karwaya hai, jaise aapke kai papers core field ke bhi hai, to it's a good, so their reaction was also very positive. So as far as I can give you the reaction, matlab my opinion about NPTEL is I think they are fine, better than any other platform, you can say. Suggestion, I would like to just say ki whenever there is some kind of error or some kind of error in any of the questions, okay, so we always look for our response which should be quick enough, because when I was solving assignment 9th or 10th, there was an error in a program. So from my side, because I was confused, it might be a correct also. So I have just raised a query against it. So for that, I got a response a little bit later. So I just wanted you all to improve in that area.
Thank you so much, sir.
Nice talking to you. Thank you so much, sir. Thanks.
Register for C course, problem solving through C. Because all the courses which were available online were not quite good, and I was being told by my seniors as well as my teachers told me it was a good program, so I decided to go for it. It was my first course.
How was the learning experience?
Basically, I will say it is a really great platform for a student like me to learn more about the thing, and also the way they teach all the things. It was quite impressive, and it was easy to understand as well.
At any point of time, we also had an opportunity to discuss the NPTEL course among your friends.
I mean, most of my friends are here itself for the course, for exams.
Do you do joint study for the NPTEL or attempting assignments, or do you on your own?
No. So initially, I did some of assignments on my own because they were from the very basics. After that, I watched the video and I learned about it. I googled some things, and basically, it was so easy to operate. And the questions and the logic which were discussed, it was like on the easier side. There was no point on that I needed any support, except the NPTEL side.
Santanu Singh, and I was basically enrolled for the course of Operation and Supply Chain Management. Everything is good, like the data, whatever is available over there by the faculties, it's quite better. The only thing I want to add on is whenever you prepare any kind of module, So if you have certain kind of like questions are available over there, like for an exam, whatever questions we are getting in the exam or whatever questions we are getting in the as an assignment. So what happens in the module, whatever the faculty is teaching, they are not elaborating the entire process of how to solve the question. See, if there is a linear programming problem, so the linear programming problem is not entirely solved while solving the question. So they are like directly saying that using the linear program you will get certain values. So certain values, how we are actually getting, we are not in a position to solve it, because the iterations that we need to do, it goes to 5-6 pages. So they will simply tell one step, and finally we have to do some 16-17 steps that goes up to like 5-6 pages. So that thing I want to tell, like if there is any certain process of solving those questions, kindly add that also in the this lecture, because we are not in a position to solve the questions. Basically, once we get the assignment, we are not in a position to solve those questions, because even a single problem of that type is not solved in the module. I use the forum, but the thing is, I don't get instant reply, or the reply may be coming after some time, but everything is fine. The explanation, whatever they are giving, like if you are teaching some topic, the explanation is completely fine. The only problem I faced on my side that I want to express is, like, I'm not in a position to solve the questions, which are quite difficult, or whatever, it is not available in the normal textbook also. Like, there is transportation problems, some similar, like the normal transportation problem are available in the textbooks, but whatever textbooks we are having in our libraries or in our normal day-to-day life, whatever we are going through the books, those kind of questions are not there. If those kind of questions are not there, then we are not in a position to solve it. Like the difficult one, like Holt's model and all, they are not available in the books easily. There are some kind of models which are like available on Excel. So if that is available on Excel, then there might be some programming behind that, and I'm not in a position to program that thing manually. So I cannot solve a question which needs some kind of iterations that is done by a software. So, and everything is good over there, because the sound, the quality of videos that you are uploading, the explanations very good, and after that the voice, the quality of video. The only thing is, when you make a video, there is a problem with the students. What they face is the quality of video is not good. If the quality of video is not good, the audio is not good, or whenever they are watching the blackboard, if the blackboard is like tilting, like if he is the camera person, he is facing on the blackboard. Course was operation and supply chain management. Operations and supply chain management. You go to module number 11 or 12, the inventory model and the transportation model. Yeah, so if you go to that modules, the blackboard will be somehow, it will be lifting like this. So I'm not in a position to see whatever is going on over there. It should not happen, but it was happening. Okay. So I want to tell that thing also. Yeah. So only there was a problem in that module. So, the different modules, there is not any kind of those kind of problem over there. So the only thing is on some four modules.
Writing on a tablet, interactive tablet.
No, he was not writing on the tablet. So for the entire course, my faculty was teaching on the black, this green board. So it was like a chalk and talk. So he was not using that digital this thing screen.
My name is Pooja, and I have given NPTEL exam today. It was actually including three sections. It was good. Some questions were tough. Maximum in the third section. Otherwise, fourth section was easy, and middle one was okay. It took time to solve questions in third section. I like the questions, the way they choose the questions. Tricky questions are there, very tricky questions, and your mind will be like, how to do that? And that is good, and you'll definitely get some knowledge from it. Everything was very good. Actually, I'm a little bit busy with my son. He is very young, just 1 year and 3 months old. So I generally don't get time to get those people. Actually, this is my favorite subject, C language, and I used to teach this in college. So I'm very handy with it. Not very much, because NPTEL finds out the typical things among those, so hum log bhi kai baar confused ho jate hain. Not very much, but I find this subject interesting, and it is one of my favorite subjects, so I generally get interested in those questions.
So I'm Dr. Hem Mohan from SRM University, Sonipat, Haryana. I today came for write the theory of computation exams. So this will give the enhanced knowledge which I can develop myself, which can be helpful for the students when I'm going to be like a part of the IIT. So this, the gap between the private institute and the IITs, it will be like this courses, more courses from the MHRD. I feel it will be, gap is fulfilling. So that's I to be participate in that. The course structure is, I'm not feeling like a difficult or hard. So it, whatever the structure, we have to be following that one. So at so it's a equal platform. It will be as like a faculty. I want to be enhance the knowledge than the students, then only I can able to update for them. So it's good platform for, it should be equal, want to be the equal, it not to be the separate from faculty and students. So sometimes the students can have the knowledge of particular part which not be the faculty. So when we are discussing the same topic with the students, if it is the same platform, we can able to discuss with the students. They give the ideas which we not have at all. If it is a different platform, it will be very difficult for that one. So it's good for the common platform. Before starting the courses, what are the courses available? If particular subject I was teaching, it's available in NPTEL or not. So first we are giving the instructing the students to at least to give the assignments. Most of the students are here to give the exams. They used to see if it is failed, the 1,000 rupees is waste. So now we are encouraging the student at least to give the assignment one by step by step. Then we are following them to give the exams. So we keep on continuing this one for the few students will be, if I am registered the same course, I ask them student to register also. When the assignment was given, who are registered in that, we used to discuss with the students, so particular assignments is there. I was getting this answer. What is the answer for you people? You are find it out. So before we are giving, assignment we have 10 or 15 days timing. So we used to discuss with the students. Students will come and ask me, sir, what the answer you are getting. So I'm getting this answer. And so if the answer is different, we sit together and find what is to be done. So that we are doing now. The few information, logic information is, we feel not able to find it out. In the books, some clarifications are less. In video, I think it's video is not possible to explain all those things. But if few content are irrelevant, mistakes are there in the content, in the subject. So we are getting the confusions in that content.
But did you convey this?
In the forum, keep on we are giving this instruction. In the assignment, few questions are wrong. And when question is wrong and the particular answer is not there, and like none of this also answer was not there. So we have to adopt any one of the answer. In that case, little bit confusions will be.
Yeah, it was very nice paper. I have already solved the assignments. So paper is based on assignments, not exactly, but questions are based on the assignment. If we are solving the NPTEL assignment regularly, then it is easy to solve the paper. The course that we are teaching, for that we are getting time. Otherwise, it's difficult to get the time for other subject. I am teaching the data mining subject in this semester, so I am getting the time for finding the new problems.
Do you normally discuss NPTEL in the class anytime?
Yeah. Generally, in the lab we are discussing, at the lab time. Because they are doing the assignment, that time we are discussing.
So they do the assignments in the class itself?
Yeah. At home also they are doing. But we are discussing some difficult questions we are discussing in the lab.
Did you find at any point of time the NPTEL lectures were very difficult to understand or something? The level was high?
Actually, that depends subject to subject. Last semester I have done for artificial intelligence. Professor was very nice and very energetic and all. This time data mining, I didn't get so much interest, but assignment I am solving. But the video lecture I didn't find that much good, that was for artificial intelligence. The video lecture quality should be improved. That is actually is a subject by subject. Na? Some teachers are very good. So last time I have done the artificial intelligence, so I thought the data mining will be also same as, so I have registered like this. But I feel the data mining subject teacher was very slow teaching. Okay. Exam center is very horrible. basically, if I am bringing the water bottle, some students are taking the water bottle in the class, but they don't allow me to take the water bottle in the class. And even at the gate, they didn't give any information. So I brought it here. Then in the summer at 1:30, they are saying you go back and submit at the gate. You can't imagine, that was a very horrible situation. There was too much dust, and I went there, then I come back. And some students are taking the water bottle inside the classrooms. If it is not allowed for one, so it should not be for anyone. But the guard is saying, no, you keep all these things at the gate. And gate is on the road. Just on the road, the gate is there. It's very difficult. I feel I'm also working in one engineering college. Students are coming for the exams. We are providing the support. Then you can keep your this somewhere here. They can say that you take your money if they are having the problem like this, the mobile phone and money, someone is taken. So they can say you take your money yourself. You should be carry with yourself. But if I am keeping the umbrella, what is there, I bring my umbrella, I bring my bottle, they are saying you go back and keep it on there. And the gate was on the road. They can provide somewhere here for this type of the facility.
My name is Shrikant, and currently I'm working as a soft skill trainer with Kite Group of Institution. And I think this is a blessing in disguise, and it's a very nice course. And this was on enhancing soft skills and personality development. And the kind of delivery that was done by Dr. T. Ravichandran, and I think it was really insightful, and it has helped me to really develop myself, and I think I'll be able to translate this into the classroom as well. It was, in fact, the information that we got from, it was from the college coordinator actually. The college coordinator in fact initiated, and the director of our college was, he took the initiative, and he in fact made it mandatory for everyone to, enroll for this one NPTEL course. So this is how we came to know, sir. And I'm more motivated to do further courses as well, because for us it's important that we try to do value addition in the course, and so that we make it helpful for the students as well.
And you normally discuss about NPTEL in the classes also?
Oh, certainly. MOOCs courses. Oh. We said that, okay, what if you are doing a specific branch in an engineering, so you have to enhance yourself, because I'm into employability enhancement training. So I tell them, so you have to upskill yourself. So in order to upskill yourself, this is a very good platform where they should, get engaged.
The subject that you have chosen is available in various many online platforms.
Right.
Was it any reason that why you have chosen only NPTEL?
See, one thing, it was being conducted by IIT Kanpur. So the brand itself attracted me actually. There is Coursera, and there are various other international platforms. But it was because it was being conducted by a very premier institution like IIT, so that was one of my motivation to do that.
Any suggestion that you'd like to tell us about?
No, sir, I think this is beautiful course. I mean, not much suggestion. I mean, this kind of things, we would like to be a part of it. That's it.
Amen. Sir, my name is Priyank Shratha. I'm an assistant professor in Ajay Kumar Garg Engineering College. It was the first time in an NPTEL.
What was the course?
Sir, soil mechanics. I have done my master's in soil mechanics only. Examination was okay, as per the quality it was okay, as well.
Tell me about yourself, your name and the course that you have taken.
Myself, Anchal Negi. I'm assistant professor in Ajay Kumar Garg Engineering College, same.
It was like, in our college was told like all the faculties up to professor level should need to appear for that exam. It was like a mandatory thing, so we... if we are giving in a competition, then another thing, we need to memorize everything, because as a teaching we have that funda, but in order to solve that thing, we need that all the calculation, all the procedure should be well known to us. So it was just a revision for us. I discussed if the student have any doubt, like they are appearing for GATE also, if there are doubt that they are doing coaching also in Medici. So if something like Kaushik Dev is there in IIT Kharagpur, I admire them only. So I also study if I have some doubts, and I also to tell my student for numerical purpose, if they have any doubts in soil, they go for NPT. So there were like some mistakes were there, correction was there, like something more can be added in that thing, like.
Here, mistake?
No, in NPTEL only there was little bit mistake was there, the correction was there, so no, but the course was.
You
Sir, we only solve assignment.
We just solve assignment.
We didn't go through the study material.
We don't go through the study material. We don't have to. We just see the assignment and solve it. Like yesterday. So sometimes we have doubt. We had not get that much time.
I'm Rashi Gupta and I'm assistant professor in Indraprastha Engineering College. The exam was very good. I have given control engineering examination. The exam was good and it was from assignments only. I have given NPTEL exam for the first time in my life. But yes, I felt very confident after giving the exam and I'll surely give the NPTEL exam in next semester onwards also. I came to know about NPTEL through my college only. In my college, Ms. Priyanka D. Gupta and Ms. Archana Agarwal are heading the NPTEL examinations. And through them, I came to know about NPTEL from the last 3 to 4 semesters. But I gave NPTEL exams for the very first time in this semester only. I got a feeling of being a student again because I was very afraid of giving the examination. I was not able to learn the the formulas. And I felt that after being a faculty, learning the formulas is a very tough task. But yes, I will give an NPTEL examination from the coming semester because if I concerned about the subject, then yes, I felt very confident after giving the examination that yes, we as a faculty member also can do something in our. I'm not a PhD holder right now, but I think that particular certificate will help me in clearing the entrance examination for PhD. I have given control engineering examination, so I think that control engineering is now a subject which I have prepared for my PhD entrance. So from next semester, I'll try to learn another subject. If I talk about control engineering, so there were questions from the assignment, but in the assignment there were options. But here they gave you have to write the answer in the whole number. So in that part I faced somewhat little difficulty. Suppose my answer was K should be greater than 64. But in that you have to write a whole number. So in that case, what should I write? I have written 65 because it should be greater than 64. So for in that case, what should we have written? In the option, in the assignment, there were options. There was option 128, 264. So I have in the assignment I have marked 128 and 256. But here I cannot write my K should be greater than equal to 64. So that's the problem I faced in the examination.
Tech from Art Engineering College. I just want to complete my dreams. So I pursuing B.Tech. And it's my mom's dream. That's why I'm pursuing B.Tech. Structure is something unique which I want. Now I can do with this and I'm satisfied with this.
Name of the course was Mathematical Methods and Application. To teach in class is a bit different as compared to solving. To teach the concept and to solve till the last step do take time. The types of questions was very good. So many good questions were there, not only basic but high level questions were there, good questions were there. Lectures are very elaborate, if you haven't studied anything, still you can get. They are in good continuation. Nice lectures.
Thank you. Manish Kumar Singh from KIT Ghaziabad. Digital Communication, Principal of Digital Communication. It was very good. Everything is clearly explained, but paper was difficult. Very few questions come from assignment.
My name is Pradeep Chauhan and my exam is C programming, MIT Meerut.
Right. You come from Meerut to write the exam?
No sir, I am living in Ghaziabad, so I choose the center. I have not enough time to study more because the work of college, otherwise good.
Exam pattern is very good. My exam was very good.
Which was exam?
Soil engineering, geotechnical. I am teaching soil mechanics. And I want to expertise in this branch, so I gave this exam. Course structure was very good.
Your faculty?
I'm faculty.
No, the faculty.
One suggestion is only that exam pattern should be objective. There is fill in the blanks type question. If possible, give all the question objective questions, choice based questions.
Said from KIT Group of Institutions, Ghaziabad, I have opted the course Mathematical Methods and Application. It is a basic course, so I am very interesting questions are given and I am very much satisfied. I have attempted all the questions. and I am little bit confident and most of them will be. From my point of view, it should be little bit change. You can see in the last NPTEL same course, almost assignments are also the same. Some questions are different. So this course is running from last many years. So it should be little bit change. Forum assignment, all things are okay, but I think that if we are repeating the course, then there should be some new module for the faculties. They should be learn more and more. Yes, I am discussing. I am very much big fan of NPTEL.
C programming, problem solving with C. Yes, my experience according to NPTEL is great. They explain everything nicely. And they have also assignment option, which is great. I have time to submit all the assignment, but sometimes I have suffered that I lack of answering the questions regarding the taking the options.
How do you normally learn the NPTEL? Using the mobile phone or laptop?
Yeah, mainly using the laptop. Okay.
At home or in the college?
At home.
Do you discuss the NPTEL thing also in the college?
Yes, with one of my two or friend.
They are also writing the same exam?
No, they are also not. They are not. Because they have, they haven't submitted the exam, that 1100 fee.
Oh, I see. Was the fees too expensive or?
No, it's not too expensive and there also scholarship option is there. I have heard from my senior that NPTEL certificate has value, but I really don't know whether it is had or not. It was not forced me. I selected because I'm interested in programming.
Then how did you come to know of NPTEL?
My senior told me.
He also attempted exams?
Yeah, he also attempted the exam, but not the same.
What is your next course going to be?
Don't know.
My name is Neha Khwadia. I am pursuing in BTech fourth year with branch CS, Computer Science. I am placed in NIIT. I am currently in 10th stress GCS. And there are so many my dreams, like to be a CEO of big MNC, to travel foreign, to complete my MBA from CAT, and also I have five members in my family. My sister pursuing in CA, my father is a businessman, my mother is a housewife, and my brother, younger brother, is also doing the BTech from same college.
Which one?
That is NPTEL, NCR.
Yeah.
In final, I don't know about this so much, but the university is compulsory, this exam compulsory for all BTech branches. Non-conventional NCR. I forget the full form, but it's something related to non-conventional economics course, which is related to the economics. And yes, I'm continuously watching the videos which they are uploaded, and they are maybe per week assignment. They are 14 or 12 assignments. I'm doing that by watching the videos, and they provide a study materials on drive.
You want to appear one more for a more exam sometime?
Yes, huh? Absolutely. That on the 7th of June, NCR.
Okay,
yes, sir. I'm appearing for that.
Same center if it comes?
Yes, sir.
I'll stand.